Hello everyone, I'm Ihsan. In this video, we'll see the latest good luck update that has just been added to the theme park module. In this update, we can change the appearance of the icon with very interesting new effects that have never been available in previous versions. One of the most interesting things is that Samsung now presents the icon display with a glass effect, like the latest glass effect on iOS 26 icon on the iPhone. Okay, now let's go straight to see what the latest features are in this good luck update. Before seeing what the latest features are, we must first install the latest theme park module update. For the theme park module that has received this latest feature update is version 1.1.1.23. And for the update, you can directly download the GoodLock application on the Galaxy Store and download the latest version of the theme park module from within the GoodLock application. And if you have updated the theme park module from the Galaxy Store but still can't get this latest version, you can also directly download the latest version of the theme park module from our Telegram channel. Then after successfully downloading and installing the latest version of theme park, we can immediately open the GoodLock application and open the theme park module. Next, select the icon tab at the bottom and select create new to create a new theme with a new icon display. The new icon theme settings will display four new icon style options. The first option is a new icon display with a film grain effect. The film grain effect settings in this icon display can be adjusted using the grayscale and noise options. The grayscale option, as you move it to the right, will fade and become paler. And moving it to the left will make the color more vibrant. The noise setting below it will adjust the intensity of the noise displayed on the icon display. At the bottom of the film grain setting, there is also a three color options. They change the background color for icons with the background behind them. Once these settings are complete, you can save and apply the effects to change the icon display on your Samsung smartphone. The icon display will immediately display with a very attractive film grain effect. Icons with the film grain effect will look like this. The second new effect is the Duotone effect. This allows you to display two different color combinations that will then appear on all icons on your Samsung smartphone. For this Duotone option, you can choose the shadow color and highlight color. And after changing the shadow and highlight colors, all icon displays on the phone will appear with those two basic colors. Then the three color setting is also available in this Duotone option, which can be changed in the far right. So if there are icons that still have a background color, the color can also be changed to match the base color in the Duotone settings, so that the colors look more harmonious. And for the icon display with the Duotone effect, it will look like this. Next, there's also the latest icon color effect. The glass effect. This effect seems to be one of Samsung's efforts to provide an icon display with a glass appearance for Samsung users. It clearly looks like the latest icon display in iOS 26 on the iPhone. However, the difference is the appearance of the glass effect on the icon display on Samsung smartphones. We can adjust the appearance again according to our personal taste. For the first setting at the very top, there is an edge settings that can be adjusted to adjust the thickness of the glass effect display. If we slide to the left, the glass effect display will be thinner. And if we slide to the right, the glass effect display will be thicker. Then below it, there is also a light setting to adjust the intensity of the light effect on the icon display. If we slide to the right, the intensity of the light effect will be stronger. And if we slide to the left, the intensity of the light effect will be dimmer. Then below it, there is also an angle option that functions to adjust the direction of the light reflections on the icon. So we can easily adjust the direction of the light reflection in any direction up to 360 degrees. Then at the very bottom, there is also an icon color option that we can change to uniform all the icon colors. Then next to it, there is also an option for the glass effect color. You can change this color if you want to change the color of the glass effect display. If you want a natural glass appearance, you don't need to change this setting. And finally, for the rightmost option, we can also adjust the color of the reflection of the light beam effect. And for the icon display with the glass effect, the display will look like this. Then the last icon effect is the gradient effect. This effect, as the name suggests, displays a color gradient effect according to the two color choices we choose. For the options, we can adjust the angle for the direction of the color gradient. To change the two basic colors of the gradient display, we can change the start color and also end color to create the gradient effect. In addition, in this effect setting, there is also an icon color option to change the color of all icons so that the color becomes one uniform color when this gradient effect is applied. For the icon display with the gradient effect, the display will look like this. And for these latest icon displays, although they come with various very interesting new effects, unfortunately there are still shortcomings in some of the icon display effects. When we check the app drawer, it turns out that there are still several applications which still missing the app icon. And the app icon do not change according to the settings we apply. Especially for the glass icon effect and also the gradient icon effect. There are some icons that do not change and even disappear in the app drawer display when we apply the glass effect and gradient effect. Meanwhile, for the foam grain effect and duotone effects, all icons can be changed according to the settings we apply. So maybe you can try using the duotone effect or film grain effect first. Because for these two effects, you can immediately use now to change the appearance of all the app icons on your Samsung smartphone. Meanwhile, the glass and gradient effects still cannot be applied to all app icons. And many applications still cannot apply these two effects. Hopefully, in the next theme park update, the glass and gradient display effect have been improved, so that we can apply the effects to all app icons. This will make the app icon display more consistent and more usable. If you have any questions about how to install or set up this latest theme park module, you can ask directly in the comment section down below. Or you can ask directly in our Telegram group. I hope you found this video helpful. See you in the next one.